I declare the motion negatived.
On see
members' motions. Four censure motions under Rule 49B, Bracket 1A of the Rules of Procedure. First motion, motion to be moved by Dr. Hon KWOK Ka-ki to censure Dr. Hon Junius HO. I call upon Dr. Hon KWOK Ka-ki to speak and move the motion. Thank you, President. I move that the motion, as printed on the agenda, be passed, and this is under Rule 49B, Bracket A of the Rules of Procedure. Well, that this Council, in accordance with Rule 79, Bracket 7 of the Basic Laws, censures Dr. Hon Junius HO for his misbehavior in breach of oath under Article 104 of the Basic Law. Well, as to the details, I would like to particularize them. On the night of the 21st of July 2019, a number of white-clad men used rods and bamboo poles to assault passengers at Yunong Station of West Rail Line of the MTR Corporation Limited and on board a train, causing bloodshed and injuries to many people, including elderly persons, children, and a pregnant woman. Before the assault, Dr. Hon Junius HO had appeared outside the station and shaken hands with a number of rod-wielding people who were in white clad and suspected of launching the assault that caused injuries to others. He had also given a thumbs up to those people suspected of launching the assault and to show his support and encouragement for their violent acts and made such supportive and encouraging remarks as, "I support you and you are my heroes." The aforesaid conduct of Dr. Hon Junius HO first constitutes misbehavior as he, as a member of the Legislative Council, openly supported and encouraged acts that may be prosecuted for assault occasioning actual bodily harm and common assault under the Offences Against the Person Ordinance, Cap 212, and this not only abated a crime but also put Hong Kong citizens in danger. And second, is in breach of the oath he made at the meeting of the LegCo on the 12th of October 2016 under Article 104 of the Basic Law and the Oaths and Declarations Ordinance, Cap 11, to serve the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region in full accordance with the law. 7/21 is a date we never forget as the people of Hong Kong. On that day at Yunong Station, there was a terrorist attack. A large number of white-clad men, according to reports, there were as many as 600 of them. On two occasions, at Yunong Station of West Rail Line, they used rods and bamboo poles to attack citizens and reporters. 45 people were injured and sent to hospital. Some had to receive a number of stitches on their heads, which had been bashed and injured. Hospitalized for a few days, a pregnant woman was injured and lied on the ground. A male passenger was on his knees begging for mercy, but he was still attacked. It is indeed a terrorist act. Well, according to the UN Convention, we have a definition for terrorist acts. If you threaten others or if you have the intention to hurt others, then it is already a terrorist act. So on that day, what happened was indeed a terrorist act. There was a large number of white-clad men with a red armband. They were suspected to have a rogue background. At the West Rail Line, in particular Yunong Station, as well as Kai Tak, they attacked the passersby as well as the passengers indiscriminately. And the poles and the rods kept raining on the passengers and the citizens. We saw everything with our own eyes. We were shocked by the screens on the TV broadcast. Many people were in bloodshed, and then female passengers were indecently assaulted during the attack. And what's so outrageous is that at that time, people dressed in firemen and ambulancemen uniforms, when they tried to help and treated the injured, they were also attacked. 45 were injured, one seriously, and five, one was critical and five seriously. And then on the following day, 22nd of July, Yunnan became a ghost town because there was a piece of information on the internet that there would be another round of attacks. Whoever appeared in the streets will be attacked. So all the shops were closed and students had to hurry home, and employees did not go home late, and they had to ask for their bosses' leave to go home early. Otherwise, come the evening, July 21st would happen again. The people of Hong Kong could never forget what happened on the 21st of July. We will be indelible in our memory. As to the passengers on the train, they were seriously injured both physically and emotionally. And I'm afraid the impact would last for months and years. And many people even stayed away from the West Rail, stayed away from Yunnan Station, stayed away from Yunnan New Town after the attack. They dare not think about the scene again. There was a 20-year-old girl who was affected, and her breasts were squeezed, and then she had her toe bones broken. At the time, there was a doctor who was attending to the victims, and he said that there was a young man who suffered serious injuries, and then a nurse took off his clothes, and then he had to be given a number of treatments. In fact, the scalp was fully attacked. And so even though he was not bleeding, but then the injury was serious, and luckily he was able to answer questions. He was still conscious, but then he was injured and beaten up all over the body. What's most shocking was that behind his neck, on the back of his neck, he had a 20 cm long wound. So he could easily have been sort of paralyzed as a result of breaking his neck bone. This is most brutal. This is more uncivilized. This is unacceptable. Some people may say that perhaps it only happened on that day at that time only. But of course not. Well, before that indiscriminate attack on the 16th of July, a number of white-clad men went to attack a number of young people who were in support of anti-extradition bill. And then a day before 21st of July, on the 20th of July, it was really odd. Somebody was interviewed in his rally supporting the police. He said that something would happen on the following day and asked the TV reporter to go there to cover the story. And Mr. Sekeng Chun, a former person in charge of a newspaper, said that people should use water pipes to beat up the young people. So it was a sort of prophetic of him. And then there were others who had received messages. The village has advised the local people not to dress in black, not to wear a facial mask, otherwise they would be beaten up. The Democrats also received such a message, and they informed the police on the Facebook posts. There were a lot of warnings saying that they had to protect themselves because the white clad would be beating up the young people. So the script was written with props, etc. And Mr. Zachary Wong from the Democratic Party felt most uneasy about it. So the day before that, he learned about the mobilization of the rural people. He rang up the PPRB of the Yunnan Police Station. He was told, he was assured that there was deployment planned. But in fact, on that day, you didn't even see a single police officer. Mr. Mark Yip Seng, another DC member, about 9-10 hours before the incident, already WhatsApped the police saying that 500 triad people would gather at Gaide and they would like to beat up those protesters coming back from the procession. And the answer given was that police was aware of it and there would be a countermeasure. But in fact, not a single policeman was seen at that time. Junius HO is a rural leader in Yunnan. He used to command a lot of respect and enjoy high status in Yunnan. He was photographed shaking hands with the white-clad man in Yunnan. At the time, the white-clad man had wooden poles and bamboo sticks in their hands. Just now, Junius Ho said that we shouldn't break the law while we are so familiar with the legal requirements. Mr. Ho is a practicing lawyer. Well, since the 20th of July, there were news that wooden poles and bamboo sticks would be used to attack the unarmed people. So how come he could still say that when he showed a thumbs up and saying that the others had to be thanked? He didn't know what he was saying. Well, for such assailants, well, we are ashamed of them and we should condemn such assailants. And yet, Junius Ho gave them a thumbs up saying that they were heroes. So these assailants became the heroes of Junius Ho. Can he keep his seat here? Can he do justice to us? Well, he's supposed to be a practicing lawyer. So for such a person to be a lawmaker, for a person of such a character, and he allowed people unarmed, totally unarmed, to be attacked in Yunnan. For the white-clad men, they said that they were driving away the cockroaches, so they didn't have to be thanked. So we're talking about a practicing lawyer. And then for such acts, he wasn't surprised. He didn't doubt and he didn't query, nothing at all. In other words, there was some tacit agreement. They would like to drive away the cockroaches. They had to beat up the people. And so he reaffirmed them, recognized their efforts, saying that they were his heroes. So the white-clad men, the assailants, were his heroes. So what sort of person have we got here? Now, he stays here to accuse others of knowing the law and breaking the law. He accused Xu Gajun and Tanya Chen for breaking the law. Is he in a position to make such a remark? I think he needs to do some soul searching. Well, he's got a doctorate degree, honorary degree from a Chinese university. It's an honorary degree from the University of Political Science and Law. Well, it is bringing shame to us. Well, in fact, we weren't aware of such a university, political science and law. Well, perhaps it fits his status. It fits his status as a practicing lawyer Ho. Well, we all know that Mr. Ho likes to have a live stream or live cast of his deeds. Well, he did so, and he said that he was aware of this group of people waiting for the black cat any time. In case Yunnan was attacked, then these people would safeguard the homes and protect the village. So I gave them some gentle reminders about the legal aspect. So practicing lawyer Ho was fully aware of that. In other words, such people were carrying out the attack in the name of protecting their homes. And he said that they were all prepared. And he said that nobody had to teach them what to do because they took the initiative to do so. What's meant by protecting your own home? If you hold wooden poles and bamboo sticks to do this, then it is tantamount to an assault, not protection, not defense. I think anybody who is a lawyer would urge them not to break the law, not to hurt others. But in fact, what has he done for such assailants? They were assailants attacking the victims, the citizens. He congratulated them, he recognized their work and gave them a thumbs up. Well, in fact, earlier on the 15th of July, in his Facebook post, he said that he welcomed the protesters to go to Yunnan. There are 27 villages, and if the protesters came, then they could do something in response. And he said that he was confident in the rural people. The more protesters, the better, because they would be beaten severely. And he said that he would not be the same like Hao Jikang. He would not be friendly with them. All of them would be beaten up, and they would be scared to death. So can anybody expect such words from somebody from the legal profession? I think we can still recall what he had said. He said, killing them mercilessly. So I think it's a lawmaker who has brought shame to us. So I urge everybody to support the motion. Thank you.
I now move the motion as printed. I propose a question to you that Mr. KWOK Ka-ki's motion be passed in accordance with Rule 49B, Book 2A of the Rules of Procedure. The debate is now adjourned and the matter stated in the motion is referred to an investigation committee. The second motion